This week on Maker Update, how to make a 3D map from cardboard, Arduino makes up with Arduino, an orbiting time-lapse rig, maker contests, maker fairs, and 3D printed designs to fuel your coffee addiction. It's Wednesday, October 5th. I'm Donald Bell, and welcome to Maker Update, Episode 5. A big thank you to all the new subscribers out there. I really appreciate you subscribing. This episode won't disappoint. Let's start with the project of the week. Over on Instructables, we have this outstanding write-up on how to fabricate your own 3D topographical map of any location in the world. There's a free online tool that I'll link to in the show notes called Terrain to STL that lets you generate your own 3D STL file of any location on Google Maps. There's also a Moon to STL spinoff for downloading sections of the moon. Now, once you have the STL file, you can import that right into Autodesk's free 123D Make program, which I'll also link to. From there, you can slice up the model into stack slices, which you can either print out as templates and transfer to a material like cardboard and then manually cut out, or send off to a laser cutter if you have access to one at work or at a local makerspace. This example uses a mixture of laser cut plywood and blue acrylic. I dabbled in this myself just using the software, and I created a model of Kauai that uses 8x11 sheets of cardboard. Totally manageable and something I could try cutting and gluing by hand just as a low stakes experiment. I really like this project because it's one of those rare projects where you could approach it just as like an excuse for some family fun time cutting and gluing, or you could go high end with it and use some really nice materials and sell these on Etsy or at your local craft fair. All right, and now for news. This past weekend at World Maker Faire in New York, Arduino co-founder Massimo Bonzi announced a reconciliation between his Arduino.cc organization and the competing Arduino.org run by Federico Musto. The two got together on stage at Maker Faire and hugged it out after 2 years of a complicated and strange legal battle. The short takeaway is that the two have agreed to an Arduino organization that's just for distributing all the Arduino boards, and an Arduino foundation that's in charge of maintaining the Arduino IDE software. And while this is all good news, you do have to wonder if this is coming too late. In the 2 years that these guys have been fighting, there's been this wave of inexpensive project boards like the Raspberry Pi Zero, the Chip, the Trinket by Adafruit, the Teensy, all of which can be had for significantly less than even the cheapest Arduino. And that's not even counting all of the counterfeits that are out there on places like eBay. And you can kind of get a sense for this in Arduino's other announcement this weekend, which is the launch of their Kickstarter for a new Arduino platform called ESLOV, or ESLOV. This is a cool-sounding plug-and-play system of Arduino modules that are geared towards making it super easy to create Internet of Things devices with a minimum of coding. So far, their funding, which still has 22 days, is pretty short of their $500,000 goal. The trouble for me is the price. You're laying out $50 minimum just to get the hub, just the one board, and if you want any modules to play with, which is kind of the point, you're gonna be spending at least $100. And either way, you're not gonna be seeing these until June of 2017. Personally, I have to think that a lot could happen in the space of 8 months in the project board space. Plus, the trend I've been seeing has been moving towards $5 computer boards, not $100 project ecosystems, though you do have to make an exception for a company like Little Bits, and maybe that's really who Arduino's going after. That would make sense. All right, and now for more projects. For you new subscribers, just to let you know, my whole thing is to keep an eye out for cool but realistically achievable projects. People seem to be into that so far, so I'm sticking with it. I think that Matt project was a great example, but so is this one. Check out this fold-out candle holder on Instructables. The whole thing is just made from straight cuts using whatever saw you have handy. It looks like you would need to be super precise to get everything to fit together so perfectly, but the trick is to just glue up a bunch of these blocks and planks at right angles, nest them together tightly into a single block, tape them up, and trim and sand everything into one uniform shape. I love it. And if you have a saw and glue and tape and sandpaper, you can totally make this happen. There are no tricky tools required, though I have to imagine it could take some practice. Also, check out this orbiting time-lapse rig. It uses an off-the-shelf time-lapse camera mount, along with PVC pipe and a selfie stick. The end result is a ceiling-mounted rig that can slowly rotate around you and capture these great dynamic time-lapse videos that I am dying to do for my own builds. All right, now you may have been wondering why I haven't mentioned any of the names of the makers for any of these projects yet, and it's because I didn't want this video to sound like a giant love letter. Because all of these projects, even the 3D maps at the top, the project of the week, they're all made by the same guy, this guy Scott McIndoe. He's currently an artist in residence at the Autodesk Pier 9 Wonder Lab, and he's killing it. He's just killing it right now on projects, and I wanted to share them all with you, all right? So thank you, Scott, for this week's inspiration. Also, a quick tip for those of you with 3D printers. I found this collection of coffee-related designs over on Thingiverse. There are a lot of espresso machine accessories here, some adapters for burr grinders, and some pour-over stands. There are also a lot of espresso tampers, which I realize now look a lot cooler when they're machined from metal. I'm sure they work just fine, but when they're plastic, they look like something you'd be very embarrassed to find in a nightstand, you know? Like, you wouldn't give one of these as a gift without being very clear about what it is. All right, contest. Last week I told you about all the Halloween-related contests over on Instructables. This week I'm going to quickly cover all of the rest. You've got Leather and Solar, ending this upcoming Monday, October 10th. Then Clay, LED, and Live Off the Land, ending October 17th. Then Dorm Hacks and Circuits, ending all the way off in November on the 21st. There are 7 maker fairs happening this weekend, most in the US, but one in France. Then there's Loveland, Cincinnati, Farmington, Baton Rouge, Charlotte, and Denton. I also want to give another plug to the upcoming East Bay Maker Fair happening Sunday, October 23rd in Oakland, California. I'll be there giving 2 talks, but we've also got the amazing Anouk Whipwrecht, my friend Mike Sinisi, executive editor of Make Magazine, Megabots will be there, the Culture Shock Dance Troupe will be there. It's going to be great, so come out and say hello. All right, so that's a wrap for episode 5 of Maker Update. One more down, okay? Thanks everyone for all of your great feedback. I think it's really helping the show move along. Leave me more comments though. I know I still don't have the perfect formula for this yet, so give me your feedback and let me know what's working for you. All right, and your shares too. Last week, a few of you shared last week's episode and it was a huge help for me. So if you could do more of that, that would be great. All right, thanks for watching. I'll see you next week.